This is Dabu 7. We have scientists now warning that this underwater fault, the Cascadia, this subduction zone 600 miles long off the west coast of the United States, can generate a megaquake, one bigger than the big one that you always hear about that's associated with California. Oftentimes, the big one is connected to an area from San Francisco south in California, from the Hayward Fault down to the San Andreas Fault. But the Cascadia, they're now saying, can generate more energy, saying that it's broke up into four different sections, and that the rock that it's made of in this area, when it compacts and compresses, can help to generate a much larger quake. They have also discovered, along the Cascadia on the ocean floor, areas running 600 miles along this whole thing that have fissures opening up, as you can see here, where these gases are releasing. They're not quite sure what to make of it, but they're saying that at this point, if a quake is triggered off this subduction zone, it's going to generate something similar to what happened in Japan in 2011, where we can see a 9+ magnitude quake. They also state that it will generate somewhere around 100-foot tsunamis that will devastate the upper west coast of the United States, areas like Vancouver, Seattle, and along the coast of Oregon there are going to get hammered hard. You can see here in this picture where they say the major danger zone is. We've known that this is an area that has a high chance of big quakes. We haven't seen it yet, and the longer that time goes by, they say the more energy is building up, and it just means there's going to be an even bigger quake when it does hit. They would like to see fives and sixes hitting in areas like this every now and then, knowing that it's releasing some energy. The fact that this thing's been locked up for so long leans toward a major quake happening. Now, we also have word of a lot of activity going down in the East Side Bay in San Francisco. This is where the Hayward fault line runs. The Cascadia would end right above this, and then you've got the Hayward that runs right through here across from San Francisco. They are stating that the geysers in this region have seen over 500 microquakes here recently. And the last time that this happened, there was only like 100, and a big quake hit in this region some years ago. So, terms of this area, if you live there, I think you should know to have a plan. You can see right here, this one that hit up here is right where the Juan de Fuca plate connects up to the Cascadia here. And really, Seattle, Vancouver, those are the target cities and areas that would get devastated the most, I would feel, in this event. But it could unzip all of California. As I just showed you, you could go down and hit the Hayward Fault, which is right outside of San Francisco, and then that connects into all these faults that went right down here into San Andreas, outside of the Salton Sea. So, the newest information here, I wanted to share it with you guys, get it out there, let it be known what's going on here with these newest updates. If you're on the West Coast, the best thing I could say is to make sure you got a plan for when this day does happen and you get to the interior of the mainland as quickly as possible. Have some kind of plan. We'll talk about this more in the next live stream. Make sure to join me. Going live Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 9 p.m. Eastern. You'll find links below. Y'all stay safe. Stay alert. Much love.